Let's start off with, it's incredible, isn't it? The NSE 20 share index and the market as a whole hitting a 20-month high yesterday.
Really, Larry, for the market, it's good news for the retail investors. Although I'm a bit cautious on it.
You can't throw caution in your second sentence. You should have talked a bit more positively before throwing caution.
Larry, the foreigners exiting follow the smart money. My economics teacher tells me that if your leader is already has left, then well, clearly they've made the foreigners look like they've made their money.
Right.
As retailers are jumping on the bandwagon. It really didn't go well for me.
So what are you saying here? That the foreigners have seen there's no more bargains to be made here and they've exited and then the local investors are coming in?
Larry, would you buy KCB at 30 bob?
Pass. just what you exactly? To say in plain English.
I'm cautiously optimistic about the market going forward. Remember, this is an election year.
Mm-hmm.
We also headed towards December. And December has always been a tipsy-turvy month.
Yes.
It's really hard. Actually, for me, the market from third quarter onwards has always been a hard read.
Yes.
So I'd be cautiously optimistic about it.
And we're coming right to the middle of the second quarter. So, of the third quarter, rather.
Yeah. So really, because once the bank stop releasing the results.
Yeah.
That's it. There's no more news to wait for.
So the fact that foreign investors were very limited in the market yesterday, you think this is going to keep up, and which means that we might not be hitting these highs for the next few days?
Look, Larry, we can't raise money to buy our own voter registration kits.
We are borrowing.
You are
for
borrowing.
That.
Yes. What does that do to the country risk? Brings it up.
Yes.
Yeah. Would that be good news to any investor coming in?
No. Not at all. Which is what I wanted to move on to. Standard Chartered, their rights issue closing in a few days, a 3.2 billion shillings rights issue. Everybody is rushing in classic Kenyan fashion for that last minute to make sure you buy in last minute. At the same time, they've given us this 8.8 billion shillings, which they're making a very tidy profit on, as it were.
It looks like in Kenya, the citizens have money. The government does not have money. Look at NIC, if you look at NIC rights, look at housing finance bonds issue, oversubscription. Look at the 2 year, actually a whooping over 100%, over 200% oversubscription. What does that mean? Government broke, citizens have money.
Which reminds me, if the government is broke and we have money, why doesn't the government borrow from us?
But they refuse to give us what we're asking for.
Yes.
At the right interest rate. I mean, Larry, I bid 14% for the 2 year. The government rejects it.
Yes.
Yeah. What's that supposed to mean?
So they appear to be keen on borrowing at a much higher rate than what ideally the market would be able to give them?
Yes, than me as a patriotic citizen.
Than you as a patriotic citizen.
Yeah.
I hope somebody from the central bank or treasury is watching this. they can get some very good points. KCB, for the first 9 months of its financial year, profits up 43%. What did you make of that?
It looks like the subsidiaries are finally breaking even.
Yes.
They contributed actually a whooping 600 million to the group profits. We also look at we've been operating in a period of interest rate volatility. Interest rates coming up, then coming down. Especially when it's been coming down, remember there's always a drag between interest on deposits and interest charge on loans. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So for me as a banker, I would like to increase my interest on deposits at a slower rate than what I would like to do on the interest on savings, because after all, I'm in business.
Because the interest income is one of the main reasons why it was able to report this, and it still remains very optimistic for the full year because of a growth in its loan book, but also a favorable economic outlook.
Yes, Larry, in my opinion, I think it's time the CBK really came in to tame interest rates.
Yes.
Yeah, because as you can see, banks are really profiting from it.
But Finance Minister Njeri, then, we were talking about this yesterday with another analyst, that he's indicated that he thinks the spread in the interest rate is too high, as much as 12%, but he's not giving us any concrete things.
Looks like the business people have a much higher yield on treasury than we do.
Yes.
As a citizens, yeah.
And that is a shame, isn't it?
It is a shame.
Let's talk about Safaricom. There's so much to talk about Safaricom yesterday. It touched a new year high at 4.35 shillings. And at the same time, Michael Joseph, the immediate former CEO of Safaricom, now at Vodafone in charge of mobile money, says they have just opened it up to this global platform for people to be able to receive money on M-Pesa from all these other global providers. But you in Kenya, its competitor in Kenya, they say we will not open it up to you because all that you mobile wants is to use our agent network.
Really, I think that is still a decision for the business executive because,
yes.
in their opinion, they say that it is not adding any value to them.
Exactly, that's what they said.
But really, don't you think Safaricom has become more of a parastatal, serving the citizens, like I told you? Citizens of Safaricom?
Because they have almost half of the population has a Safaricom line.
I think, Larry, for Safaricom, some decisions would go way beyond business
yes.
to become a social decision. What do you think?
That makes sense to a certain point, but do you think that maybe U-Mobile says they will pay them revenues, they will pay them licensing fees if it's necessary? So if I start at Safaricom, it might make sense.
The big question is, what does Safaricom have to lose by doing it? Not what it has to gain.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay, that is a great way to look at it as well. And finally, the shilling largely flat so far, especially yesterday. The government is still mopping up excess liquidity, about 12.45 billion shillings yesterday. But at least it's keeping it stable, as it were.
My worry with the government is, for how long will it continue propping up the shilling? I think it should just be let to go.
And if it lets it go, where will it go?
100.
Come on, Crispus. How soon would that happen?
No, of course no. Really, I don't see touching 100 levels anytime soon. Yeah. But remember, this is an election year.
This is an election year, fine. Yeah. And the IMF, when giving this $110 million, said, do not overspend because it's an election year.
Yes. So in that case, then, let the government keep on coming to the repo because...
I want to touch on very quickly on what you said before we wrap up, which is you said if the government stops supporting the shilling, how far do you think it will drop?
Oh, well. That is a question that is left to the market, Larry. I'm not a fortune teller, I'm an analyst.
You're being very, very brave right there by not saying